SpaceX is the leader in the space industry, and it does not appear that that will change very soon. Elon Musk's next project might include revolutionising space manufacturing. Varda Space Industries, a startup that aspires to establish in-space manufacturing facilities, will launch its first spaceship into orbit in 2023 on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. The spaceship will be in orbit for up to 3 months, testing space manufacturing technology. At the end of the mission, a re-entry capsule will return to Earth with around 40 to 60 kilograms of materials produced in orbit. According to Varda management, the firm picked SpaceX because it provided the most cost-efficient and dependable alternative for sending their spacecraft into orbit. President and co-founder of Varda Space, Delian Asparuov, stated that launch costs are a major driver of the company's finances. This explains their decision to use the cheapest possible remedy. Asparuov also commented on the new agreement, adding, "We are delighted about Varda's signing with SpaceX as its launch provider. The significant reduction in entrance barriers will allow the Varda to finally deliver the immense benefits of space to so many people on Earth, whose lives will be changed tangibly for the better as a result of microgravity manufacturing." Another reason Varda must have chosen SpaceX is that both Varda Space Business founders are well-versed in Elon Musk's enterprise. Will Bruey worked for SpaceX for over 6 years, and Delian Asparuov is a principal in the Founders Fund, which has assets in both Varda Space and SpaceX. A firm like Varda would not have been conceivable even 5 years ago. However, this firm is now not only operational, but it is also in a position to economically supply unique items that can only be made in space. All this is owing to fewer expensive launches, more stringent rules, and commoditized space hardware solutions. Bruey is enthused by the prospect of using Varda's knowledge in space to bring facilitating possibilities to Earth's greatest companies, given that extended exposure to zero gravity is not conceivable on Earth. Let us now turn our attention to the multi-million dollar question. What can you produce in space that you can't make on Earth? Certain things such as specialized semiconductors, bioprinted human organs, and BLAN, a super efficient fiber optic cable, can only be made effectively in microgravity. Space is the only area where microgravity may be found for extended periods. Varda Space is a year-old startup with bigger ambitions than most corporate giants. Its objective is to establish the world's first space factory, or more specifically, the first all-in-one space factory. The ISS should be considered the first space factory since it regularly hosts payloads from paying customers, some of which are focused on producing materials that can only be manufactured in microgravity. It should be mentioned that the volumes generated by these trials are ridiculously low. Varda Space intends to address this issue. The goods produced by these ISS tiny factories are subsequently transported down to Earth aboard one of the SpaceX Dragons, which, more than a decade after its introduction, is still the only spaceship in existence capable of transporting substantial volumes of goods from orbit to Earth. We have proved that orbital manufacturing has been taking place for many years, although on a very limited scale. So let's take a look at what the new California startup intends to do differently. The game plan for Varda Space is simple. Replicate and expand on the International Space Station's proven model for forging a path of commercialization, rather than launching many factories with small experiments to the ISS, which the crew on board is practically forced to troubleshoot and maintain. The Varda intends to construct its small satellites with tiny re-entry capsules capable of returning up to 100 kilos to Earth. Despite being launched by SpaceX on a Falcon 9, the actual spacecraft for the 2023 mission will be built by Rocket Lab. Varda disclosed that it had obtained 3 Photon satellite buses from Rocket Lab, which will act as a type of mothership for each Varda-built re-entry capsule. The Photon is built on Rocket Lab's successful Electron rocket kick stage and includes avionics, batteries, extra propellant, solar panels, and optional propulsion improvements to provide an off-the-shelf satellite bus capable of supporting and powering onboard payloads. This means that instead of having to construct and qualify their satellites, Photon allows clients to spend their time and resources on creating the payloads and services they wish to deploy. Varda Space appears to be the first firm to fully capitalise on this opportunity. However, there will undoubtedly be many more to come. Varda Space successfully disclosed that Rocket Lab has no restriction prohibiting Photon clients from launching the satellite buses they purchased on rockets not produced by Rocket Lab. This explains SpaceX's launch contract. Some specialized small satellite launchers, such as Rocket Lab's Electron, provide various advantages. However, their rates are typically relatively high. An Electron launch transporting 440 pounds to a sun-synchronous orbit is estimated to cost roughly $7.5 million. A seat on the SpaceX rideshare to a similar but not as finely customized orbit would cost the same buyer about $1 million. Rocket Lab's Photon costs a couple of million dollars and includes a propulsion system capable of refining the spacecraft's orbit after the rideshare launch. Varda's modified Photon will be one of several of Falcon 9's ride-sharing expeditions, a novel and profitable service that divides the expenses of travelling to space amongst clients by allowing them to carpool to space. SpaceX claims to reduce the cost of launch to as little as $1 million for an individual client wishing to transport up to 440 pounds of payload to a sun-synchronous orbit. Good luck to any corporation attempting to compete with that. Varda, unlike communications and imaging spacecraft, does not require a fixed orbit for its mission, other than to remain in low Earth orbit, making it perfect for rideshare missions. The only thing that counts, according to Brui, is that the orbital inclination is high enough to pass over Varda's landing spot. The re-entry capsule will touch down in an unknown place, according to Varda Space. The key to success, according to Brui, is to get overall hardware into orbit as soon as possible, and he believes it's based on how swiftly his firm has been operating. Varda announced a $42 million Series A rounds headed by Kostler Ventures and Caffeinated Capital in July. To date, Varda has raised more than $53 million. Given that the firm was created in November 2020, this is a staggering amount. Although the Varda has created a variety of high-value items, such as optical fiber and medicines, we still don't know what it plans to manufacture in space. When questioned, business co-founder and president Aspar Ruoff declined to reveal the first substance produced in space, stating that the firm will publicise it after a deal with a customer is signed. He also stated that there was a 50% probability that this would occur within the next 6 months. According to Aspar Ruoff, the company is focusing on the technology required for space manufacturing, which he claims would offer it a competitive edge. However, creating the re-entry capsule that will return the materials to Earth is by far their most difficult task at present. This statement was emphasised by Brui. Manufacturing in space could offer a unique advantage to certain companies due to its low pressure, which lowers the chance of contamination. This would save a lot of money for firms with elaborate decontamination systems. According to the website of SpaceForge, a UK-based space firm manufacturing on Earth faces various problems. Gravity, which produces buoyancy and prevents the creation of ideal alloys in metals of different densities, is the most difficult problem. Even the cleanest processes are contaminated by the Earth's vast ambient atmosphere. Maintaining severe temperatures is likewise extremely difficult on Earth. It is considerably easier to build anything in space, from cryogenic freezers to furnaces, since heat and cold cannot escape into the surrounding air as they can on Earth. Although having some advantages in space, manufacturing still confronts a few problems. For example, processes and equipment are likely to be subjected to high levels of radiations and must be able to endure exposure to solar flares. They may also be subjected to high temperatures, both hot and cold. When in orbit, it might be difficult to regulate systems and process machinery in real time from Earth. Despite these obstacles, several space corporations and government organisations remain interested. Yes, even in its early days, Varda is already facing fierce competition. For example, SpaceForge is building completely returnable satellites that are meant for manufacturing next-generation supermaterials in space. By developing a dependable return mechanism, SpaceForge hopes to accelerate the growth of the microgravity industry for high-value research and development applications by eliminating entrance barriers. Joshua Weston, the CEO of SpaceForge, basically echoed Brewery when it came to the commercial opportunity presented by the in-space manufacturing, saying that there are huge opportunities for in-space manufacture, enabling us to make space work for humanity. But there are currently significant barriers, including no dedicated platform and no soft return. The key to a commercial in-space manufacturer is an accurate, manageable return. So will Varda dominate the in-space manufacturing sector with its massive launch agreement with SpaceX? Time will tell. When do you believe in-space manufacturing will become a standard in the space industry? Comment your thoughts down below. And also, if you enjoyed watching today's video, kindly like this video and subscribe to our channel. Until then, stay tuned. Bye.